Good morning, dear students. In our last video, we learned about finite verbs. Now, in this video, we are going to learn about non-finite verbs. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, non-finite आणि finite verbs. मागच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण finite verbs बघितले. What does mean by finite verbs? Finite verbs changes according to tense, number and person. But non-finite verb does not change according to tense, person and number. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, ह्या कन्सेप्ट आधी लक्षात घ्या. Non-finite verb, it does not changes according to tense, person and number. म्हणजे वाक्याचा काळ कोणताही असू दे, non-finite verb change होत नाही. Person, सब्जेक्ट हा फर्स्ट पर्सन, सेकंड पर्सन, थर्ड पर्सन कोणताही असू दे, तरी पण त्या वर्बमध्ये चेंज होत नाही, त्यांनाच नॉन फिनाइट म्हटलं जातं. अँड नंबर, नंबर मीन्स व्हॉट? सिंग्युलर अँड प्लुरल. मीन्स द आयदर सब्जेक्ट इज सिंग्युलर ऑर प्लुरल, द वर्ब विच डज नॉट चेंज इज कॉल्ड नॉन फिनाइट वर्ब. नाउ लेट्स सी इन दिस एग्जाम्पल. दे प्लेड विथ मूव्हिंग टॉयज. विच इज द वर्ब इन दिस सेंटेन्स? प्लेड. Played is verb. Now see the second. They are playing with moving toys. Now in this sentence is of past tense, but are playing is of present continuous. If we change tense of the sentence, then automatically there is a change in verb, main verb. It changes in playing. विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो, जर वाक्याचा काळ बदलला तर त्या वर्ब मध्ये सुद्धा बदल होतो. तिसरे उदाहरण बघूया. ही प्लेस विथ मूव्हिंग टॉयज. इन दिस सेंटेन्स वी चेंज सब्जेक्ट. ही इज थर्ड पर्सन सिंग्युलर, दे आर थर्ड पर्सन प्लुरल. मीन्स इफ पर्सन चेंज, देर इज अ चेंज इन वर्ब. ह्या प्लेईंगचा काय झाला? प्लेस. म्हणजे जर आपण काळ बदलला, पर्सन बदलला किंवा नंबर बदलला, तर ज्या वर्बमध्ये बदल होतात त्यांना काय म्हटलं जातं? फिनाइट वर्ब. Now see, there is another verb also in the sentence, moving. Moving is also verb. They played with the moving toys. They are playing with the moving toys. They plays with moving toys. If you see, this verb doesn't change, though there is a change in number, tense or person. Means काय की जे क्रियापद सब्जेक्ट कोणत्याही पर्सनचा असू दे, एकवचन अनेकवचन असू दे किंवा टेन्स बदल असू दे, ज्या वर्बमध्ये बदल होत नाही त्यांनाच काय म्हटलं जातं? नॉन फिनाइट वर्ब्स. अँड इन ग्रामर दिस नॉन फिनाइट वर्ब्स हॅव डिफरंट कन्सेप्ट. सम केम ॲज इन्फिनेटिव्स, सम आर नोन ॲज जिरेंड अँड सम आर नोन ॲज पार्टिसिपल्स. नाउ लेट सी इन फर्स्ट सेंटेन्स. दॅट स्लीपिंग कॅट इज माइन. विच इज द वर्ब हियर? स्लीपिंग. Is also verb, but sleeping is non-finite verb. And this sleeping, it describes cat. So which word is describing? Means which non-finite verb denotes as adjective is called participle. Yalas kay mhatlo jato? Participle. Jo non-finite verb adjective sa kaam karto, tyala kay mhatlo jato? Participle. Now see the second example. Running is good exercise. In this sentence, is also verb and running is non-finite verb. Now this running function as a noun, so it is called gerund. याला काय म्हटलं जातं? gerund. की जो non-finite verb noun म्हणून काम करतो किंवा सब्जेक्टच्या जागेवर काम करतो त्याला काय म्हटलं जातं? gerund. Now see this sentence. Uma went to Mumbai to find a job. Here also two verbs, went and to find. Went is finite verb, but to find is non-finite verb. Which verb is added with to is called as infinitives. Yala kaay mhatlo jato? Infinitives. Vidyarthi mitranno, pudhche example pan baga. The sky was filled with shining stars. Two verb came. was filled and shining. This shining is function as adjective, so it is participle. Smoking is injurious to health. Smoking, this verb function as noun, so it is gerund. And see the last example, Aman likes to learn new things. Here also two verb came, likes and to learn. Like changes according to subject, so it is finite verb. But to learn is does not change according to number, person or tense, so it is non-finite verb. But this added with to, so it is infinitive. So friends, in this way, once again let me remind you, what does mean by non-finite verb? Non-finite verb does not change according to number, person and tense. Understood? And these are called as infinitives, gerund and participles. Write it down in your notebooks and practice more examples. Thank you.